There are lots of videos about cellulite and lots of research papers. A lot of people have tried to explain the mystery of cellulite, a mystery that if you've been outside today, you've seen has not been solved. We have not been able to solve cellulite. And I think the reason for this is we've missed an important and obvious explanation hiding in plain sight. So today, we're going to explain cellulite, and our explanation will answer three important questions. First, why do women get cellulite far more commonly than men, right? Question number two, why do even skinny women get cellulite? And question number three, why does cellulite appear predominantly on the butt and thighs and not in other areas of the body? Are you excited? Let's go. A convincing explanation for cellulite should answer three questions. Why women and not men, right? Why do so many women get it and why do so few men get it? Why do skinny women get cellulite? 80 to 90% of women post-puberty have cellulite. That means there are lots of skinny women with cellulite. Why is that? And why the thighs and buttocks? Why not the arms, chest, belly? Why does cellulite appear predominantly in the thighs and buttocks? Our first step is to just take a look at the hallmarks of cellulite. So this is something we can all agree on. We know what cellulite looks like. There are two characteristic features. There's the dimple or pit represented by these buttons on this mattress. And then there's the bulge between the pits, pit and bulge, right? We know what cellulite looks like. Everyone can agree about that. And now let's take a look at why the most common explanations for cellulite are deficient. But our fundamental understanding for what's causing cellulite is wrong. It's missing a very important factor. So this is the best example I could find on the internet of a diagram that explained cellulite. The others were even worse. Now, in this diagram from a med spa is showing the characteristic features that we noted from the previous slide, the pits and the nodules, right? You see the pits and the nodules, and they seem to provide this explanation, right? These three factors that are explaining the pits and nodules. They say that there's a herniation of fat. So the fat is seeping into the dermis. Well, this is patently false because we have fat in the dermis. There's dermal white adipose tissue. It's in the dermis. So the idea that a herniation of fat into the dermis is causing this pits and nodules is false on its face. Now here's the second part of their explanation. Adipose tissue in tight compartments swells up, causing nodules, right? But here's the problem. What's causing the swelling? Why is the swelling only happening in women and not men? And why is it only happening in the buttocks and the thighs and not anywhere else, right? So this is not a great explanation. So the final one, vertical septae. This has been seized on by a lot of researchers and derms and influencers. Women have these vertical septi. They're not completely vertical. They're more vertical for women than for men. But here's why this explanation is insufficient. Women have the same vertical septi everywhere, right? On their arms, their chest, their calves. But the cellulite is only appearing in the butt and the thighs, right? So if vertical septi were the explanation, we'd see them everywhere, but we don't. So we need a better explanation. And now let's take a look at what's really going on in the skin of subjects with cellulite. This is fascinating.
Fortunately, we can actually see what's going on in cellulite tissue. This is from an excellent paper that looked at the histology of cellulite tissue, and they had some really clear findings. The first one is that they saw giant adipocytes. So this is giant adipose cells, right? This is not my word. This is theirs. And here's a giant adipocyte. So this is a giant adipocyte, and this is a smaller size adipocyte. So you can see these are huge, right? Giant adipocyte, and what they write is completely non-existent microcirculation. Now they only looked at blood vessels. They didn't look at the lymphatic system, but usually that mirrors the circulatory system. And so we see that there's really nothing going in to this tissue. There's very few nutrients going in and probably very little going out, but that's just a hypothesis. The other thing that they found was disordered collagen and elastin in the dermis. So this is what they see here. In the dermis was present alteration of structural architecture of collagen and elastic fibers. The former have a disordered orientation,
The latter are shortened and in some points appear fragmented. So the dermis is fragmented and disordered. So in other words, they see weak skin, right? So now we have a pretty good explanation for the nodule, for the bulge. It's bulging because the skin is weak. Now here's the other finding. They found a fibrotic thickening of the collagen that delimited the lobules. Let me explain what they're talking about. So remember the septi that we saw in the previous cartoon? Well, the septi are collagen that delimits or organizes the fat lobule. So the fat cells aren't just floating in space. They have these septi running through them that organize them. And in the cellulite tissue, these septi are fibrotic. They're thickened. And so this is actually a great explanation for the pits, because these fibrotic, thickened septi are pulling on the skin, creating the dimple or pit, right? So now we have an explanation for what's actually going on. All right, and now we're ready for a root cause explanation for cellulite. It starts with the large fat cells.
Let's take a look at an explanation for those giant fat cells being a root cause of cellulite. So here we have in the yellow, the giant fat cells. And what they do is they recruit immune cells, macrophages. And the interplay of the fat cells and the macrophage cause a release of lots of inflammatory cytokines, IL-6, TNF-alpha, leptin-resistant, LL-37. This is just a small portion of the number of inflammatory markers that are significantly enhanced. And here the fat cells don't have to be dramatically bigger. As we saw in a previous episode on Educator, even a 10% increase in fat cell size can unleash a 100, 300% increase in inflammatory markers. So this is a really good explanation for why skinny women can get cellulite, because even though they may not have gigantic fat cells, there's still an enlargement of fat cells that can create an inflammatory response. And so here we have the symbol of the inflammation, and it does two important things. The residual fibroblasts, the ones who are normally in the skin making collagen and elastin, they become dormant. They shut down, stop making collagen, stop making elastin. And as a result, we get a disordered architecture in the dermis, right? So this inflammation can explain the nodule or bulging through the weak skin caused by the dormant fibroblasts. Now, it can also explain the thickened and fibrotic septa, because the inflammation recruits a different type of fibroblast, a myofibroblast that's going to be making scar tissue. And in the context of inflammation, you're going to get the shortened, thickened, unelastic septa that's creating the pits. Right? So this is our root cause explanation. Now, we've shared this information before on how bloated fat cells undermine skin strength, but it's useful for taking another look. So the collagen production from bloated fat cells decreases by 70%, right? It's significantly decreased. So when the fat cells get big, they turn off collagen production by signaling to the fibroblasts to stop. They also turn off elastin production, and they unleash dramatic increase in collagen degrading enzymes. So bloated fat cells can perfectly explain the disordered architecture that we saw in the histology. And now we're going to see a picture that's worth a thousand words, or in this case, one really important word, fibrosis. This was my aha moment where I said, wow, I think this could explain cellulite. And this was a post from SPA in Bakersfield, California, Body Studio LLC. And they showed this dimpling and bulging, right? It looks like cellulite, but it wasn't. It was the ramifications of a shin lipoplasty procedure where they took fat out of this person's chin and they got fibrosis. So fibrosis was the word from Bodio Studio LLC that really keyed my understanding. There's a fibrotic process here that is very similar in appearance to cellulite, and it reproduces the nodules and the pits, right? Fibrotic septi, we've got fibrosis here.
So now we're going to take a look at a study that expands our one picture to a systematic explanation of an important mechanism.
That would be one thing if we just had this one picture, this one anecdote. But we have a lot more. We actually have a biopsy-proven clinical study. In this clinical study, they didn't do liposuction. What they did was they injected a compound, ATX-101, which is a formulation of deoxycholic acid. And deoxycholic acid kills the fat cells, causing the cell membrane to break down and the adipocytes to burst. And what they saw in this study was a significant local inflammation and, here we go, fibrotic septal thickening, right? Inflammation and fibrotic septal thickening. And this was caused by recruitment of macrophages and fibroblasts, the myofibroblasts. So this validates exactly what we proposed in the previous slide, that when you have inflammation in the fat tissue, you're going to get, let's use their words, thickened fibrous septa. Now let's take a closer look. So you start out with healthy adipocytes. You add this deoxycholic acid. It causes the adipocytes to burst. This triggers an inflammatory response where you have macrophages, as we showed before, and a myofibroblast, a fibroblast that causes fibrosis, right? Then you have inflammation subsiding, but the inflammation is causing thickening of the septa. And this continues for some time beyond the inflammation. So you have a clear-cut explanation for how inflammation in adipose tissue leads to fibrotic septa. So now that we have a root cause explanation for how enlarged fat cells cause cellulite, let's go back and review the three questions that we started with. So question number one, why women and not men? Well, women have larger fat cells to start with. For women, the average diameter of dermal fat cell is 80 to 100 micrometers. And for men, the average size is 70 to 85 micrometers. So that difference of 10 to 15 micrometers is very significant. It's enough to trigger a huge increase in inflammation. And this is a big part of the explanation for why women get cellulite and men don't. So question number two, why skinny women? Well, as we just discussed, a small increase in fat cell size can trigger inflammation. So in skinny women with a BMI of 22 or 23, you can still have enough of an increase in fat cell size to trigger a 100% increase in inflammation. So in other words, you have to be extremely skinny for fat cells not to be inflamed in certain parts of the body. So question number three, why the butt and the thighs? Well, one part of this explanation is that the dermal fat cells in the butt and the thighs are significantly larger than the arms and the chest. So 20 to 40 micrometer larger. This is a huge increase. The other factor, which we haven't explored here, is the impact of microcirculation and lymphatic drainage in these tissues. It seems to be that in the butt and the thighs, you have less microcirculation and less lymphatic clearance, which may explain why those fat cells are so much bigger. Amazing, right? We're able to answer the three questions very simply with a fat size-centric view of cellulite. And I'm curious, does it make sense? Have we made the case for large fat cells as the proximate cause of cellulite? Now, some of you may ask, well, what about lymphatics? I've always heard that the lymphatics are important in cellulite. And yes, lymphatics are important. Poorly functioning lymphatic system directly feeds the size of fat cells. So if you have a poorly functioning lymphatic system, you're going to have large fat cells. We're going to take this on in a separate episode, but just wanted to cover that and make it clear that that's an important piece of the puzzle. I hope this has been as interesting for you and as satisfying as it's been for me. Thank you very much. Take care.